What up, agents? Prime here. Tuesday, vendor reset, and we can find a few decent buys. Are you ready? Let's go! What up, guys? Welcome to another Division 2 video. Thanks for clicking my content. Really appreciate you watching it. If you like my content and want to help the channel out, don't forget to smash that like button. And today, Tuesday, vendor reset day. So let's start with the White House, shall we? First thing is the everyday carrier from the Bellstone Armory. Of course, that perfectly efficient on there. 115k armor, 8.6% status, and hazard protection. Could be a little bit better, but if you're looking for this, then maybe roll that status effect away for whatever you think is necessary. I'm not loving the guns, not at the White House. For me, they need to be god rolled or very high rolled to pick them up. Over to the backpack from Seska, and this could be something because you can combine this with your crit skill build. It already has combined arms, it already have that skill damage on there and the critical hit damage. So the only thing you have to do is roll that weapon damage higher or roll that weapon damage away for a skill tier. You have a pretty decent backpack for your crit skill build. Over to the Murakami. Not great if you ask me. I'm not loving the explosive delivery and the weapon handling isn't great. Over to the mods. 10% critical hit damage, 4.1% damage for your drone, 5.7% duration for your turret, and 4.7% blast radius for your sticky payload. So let's head over to the clan. And there we are, guys, at the clan vendor. And look at this, right out the bat, the best buy of this week. 12.8% weapon damage and 5.2% critical hit chance on the Fox's Prayer knee pads. Of course, at 8% damage to target out of cover. This is a must buy, guys. Roll that weapon damage to that max cap, or even roll the weapon damage away for some skill damage so you can use it with your crit skill damage build, one of the most popular and hardest hitting build in the game at this moment. Over to the True Patriot. Again, 170k armor maxed out, so again, this is a buy. A must buy in my opinion, because you can roll the explosive resistance away for whatever you like. Just buy it if you don't love True Patriot now. Maybe there's a buff in the future, or there is something else we can work with. Of course, this is a must buy for me as well. Tip of the Spear, 5% critical hit chance and 12.1% weapon damage on a vest. Could be nice as well if you're still looking for it. Buy it, roll that weapon damage to that max cap, and you have a very nice vest. Backpack for Hunter's Fury, maxed out weapon damage, 15%. Definite pickup. Roll that skill repair or the repel scare for whatever you like, and you have a god roll backpack. Over to the guns. Not loving that. A little bit better than the ones at the White House, but still not loving it. I would rather go for the open world, especially for those LMGs. Backpack from Petrov could be nice as well, but it's a rainbow roll and wicked on there. I would love to see that skill damage for some status effect, and this could be a way better backpack. But now, just leave it here, guys. SASG, same, the guns aren't that great. Over to the 4.9% critical hit chance, 8.9% hazard protection on a Richter and Kaiser holster. Could be nice as well, but again, it's a rainbow roll. And in my opinion, the hazard protection you don't want on a Richter and Kaiser, maybe combine it then with some repair skills for yourself to keep yourself alive. And yeah, the critical hit chance could be nice as well, but then roll the hazard protection away for the repair skills or whatever you like to go with this build. But in my opinion, you could go better for two yellows than a yellow and a red or a yellow and a blue. Over to the mask from Araldi. Very nice as well, 11% weapon damage, 4.6% critical hit chance, and it gives you the opportunity to Keep the explosive resistance if you love it on there. I'm not liking it. But then roll that weapon damage to that max cap, or even roll the explosive resistance to a decent mask. Decent, not great, but decent. Over to the mods, 8.7% disrupt resistance, 2 extra bombs for your drone, 5.2% skill haste for your mine, and 6.3% heal for your cam launcher. So let's head over to the campus and see what they sell us. And there we are, guys, at the campus. The first thing is the Night Watcher, but in my opinion, this isn't a great buy. I'm not loving the 100% scan pulse haste. It's not great if you ask me. It could be nice if you want to go for that armor regeneration, maybe for some PvP build, but why would you do that? In my opinion, just leave it here. Custom M44, a gun again, not great. If you like to go with this, then roll that headshot damage to that max cap. You have a decent one. Tactical M249, same, not a great buy. Murakami, I don't know if you like the critical hit chance on there or even the status effect. In my opinion, just leave it here. Richter and Kaiser, just the same. Status effect and headshot damage. We talked already about this. I would rather see something else, some incoming repair or something that can protect you if you go for the Richter and Kaiser. Over to the mods, 10% skill haste, 1 extra ammo for your cam launcher, 4.3% duration for your hive, 4.9% skill haste for your pulse, and 4.1% duration for your shock traps. Well, let's see if the theater sells us a little bit better than the campus. Starting off with the Culebre, and yeah, just leave it here, guys. It's not a great roll, and I'm not a fan of the shotguns in the game. Custom M870. Same, you don't want it with Sadist or with the magazine size, the rest is too low to buy. Same as for the rifles. Over to the Fenris gloves, 2 yellows on there, skill haste and status effect, no thank you. Knee pads from Providence could be nice, but there are way better out there, because you want that skill repair or repair skills away, or even the headshot damage away, and then the weapon damage too low to buy. Over to the mods, 8.3 blind death resistance, over to the 6.4% health for your mine, 4.1% holster regeneration for your shield, 5.9% skill haste for your firefly, and 5.5% duration for your decoy. So let's head over to the DZs and see what they sell us. And there we are at our first DZ. DZ's, the new reliable, is the first thing we can leave here, especially for the 152 DZ credits. M44, same, just leave it here, not worth it. Black Market RPK, same. Mask from Aces of Age, too low in weapon damage. If you like to buy it, then keep that 5.1% critical hit chance on there. Could be nice, but yeah, I don't know if you want to spend 109 DZ credits only for that 5.1 critical hit chance so you can roll the weapon damage to that max cap. Hunter's Fury, just leave it here. 9.3% weapon damage, 8.8 skill damage, no thank you. Mask from Gilligard, hazard protection and weapon handling on there. You want that weapon handling away, and then in my opinion, you would love to see the armor a little bit higher. Over to the Walker and Harris, could be nice, but again, too low in rolls to buy in my opinion. 10.7% weapon and only 4.1% critical hit chance, and you don't want that headshot damage on there. Or if you want that headshot damage on there, you would love to see it a little bit higher. Over to the mods, and you know my opinion about the DZ mods, guys. Just leave it here, farming in the open world, farming in the summit, or even buy them in the open world vendors. Over to the next DZ. And there we are, next DZ, DZ South, and beginning with the Devil's Due. Of course, that perfect clutch on there, but clutch isn't doing that much for us in the game anymore. They pretty much broke clutch a long time ago. And then, I don't know if you like it with headshot damage on there, because you need to be close, most likely fighting with an SMG, and I don't know if you like SMG build with headshot on there. And then explosive resistance, you want that away, or if you want it on there, that 4.7% is way too low. MP7, leave it here. FAL, the same. Drops a lot in the open world. Decent assault rifle, but not buying this at all. X45, same. Backpack from Ongoing Directive. Only 11% weapon damage, and you do not want that health on there. Over to the Eclipse. Remember, craft this. Never buy this. You will always craft it God rolled, because you only have that skill tier on there, and you can roll that attribute for whatever you like. Backpack from Fenris could be a little bit better, especially in the weapon damage and then weapon handling and opportunistic on there. You need a marksman rifle or a shotgun drawn, so yeah, not great on a Fenris piece. Overlord, 10.4% weapon damage, 10.2% critical hit damage, and 10% skill haste, and glass cannon on there. This could be a decent buy if you want to go for that skill haste, because in my opinion, that weapon damage needs to be raised. And then, again, mods, just farming in the open world, summit, whatever, do not buy them in the DZs. Last DZ, guys. And there we are, last DZ, DZ West. First thing we can pick up are the Firm Handshake. Or yeah, in my opinion, just leave him here. They're pretty nice with the 4.6% critical hit chance, so you can roll that weapon damage to that max cap, but I don't know about the 152 DZ creds. KC Shotgun, no thanks. ACRSS, same, leave him here. Eclipse, craft it, never buy it. Striker knee pads could be a lot better, especially because you have weapon handling on there and 11.3% weapon damage isn't that great. Seska gloves could be better as well, only 3.5% critical hit chance, and I'm not loving the status effect on there. Would love to see something else at the status effect on there, or even the status effect a little bit higher so we can work with it. DNH knee pads, 11.9% weapon damage, too low in my opinion, because the attributes need to change. Higher in status effect, or yeah, the weapon handling away. Mods, 8.5% a share, but why do I say it, guys? You know my opinion. Do not buy them. They're not worth it. Over to New York. And there we are, guys. First vendor in New York at Marco, the 6556. Not great if you ask me. Looks decent with the critical hit chance on there, but not loving the steady handed and too low in assault rifle damage. M700, same, leave it here. LVAO, no thank you. PX4 Storm handgun, just go for the open world, you do not need that handgun that much. Backpack from Alps, adrenaline rush on there, but it has status effect and explosive resistance, the both things that I do not want on my Alps backpack. Knee pads from Grupo, yeah, no thanks. Rainbow roll, too low in my opinion to work with it, because the 8.8% hazard protection could be nice, but then the weapon damage is too low and the skill damage on there, nah, no thank you. Over to the Alps, same skill damage, weapon handling, skill damage. I would love to see something like repair skills so you can combine it to keep yourself alive, but the skill damage and or weapon handling I'm not loving on my holster. Over to the 11% protection from elites. Maybe you can buy it for your protection from elites build if you're still looking for it. 8.4% disorient resistance, one extra cluster mine, 8% speed for your firefly, and 6.2% duration for your sticky launcher. So let's head over to the last vendor of this week. And there we are, guys, at our last vendor of New York, at Roy. Decent covert SCM G9. Not great, but finally something with close and personal. The damage you target out of cover, what you want on there, but then the core attributes are too low to buy, in my opinion. Same for the rest of the guns. Just leave him here. Not great. Badger Tough could be nice, but I'm not loving the re-insign on there. And then the 9.2% critical hit damage should be a little bit higher. Almost 140k armor, a little over 4k armor regeneration. Those are nice, but then reassigned, no thanks. So you need to roll that talent if you want to use it. Or, yeah, in my opinion, you need to roll that talent if you want to use it. So, in my opinion, then, just leave it here. China Light, 7.3% skill damage already on there. Could be nice, but in my opinion, yeah, you don't use a China Light that much for your skill damage build. Maybe for your mines, of course, to get that explosive damage on there, but not for the skill ace, not for the status effect, and then you would rather see something else. So in my opinion, there are better gloves out there. Petrov, no thank you. The armor regeneration too low, the weapon handling on there, nah. Mods, 8.3% burn resistance, 8.5% blind death resistance, 4.2% deflector damage for your shield, 7.6% share duration for your chem launcher, and 6.4% duration for your sticky payload. But yeah guys, that's pretty much it for the vendor reset of this week. Of course, tomorrow, Cassie Mendoza to close this vendor reset. But for today, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Don't forget to smash that like button and hit that subscribers button. And of course, the notification bell. Pure Prime out.